In this video, we're going to practice matching differential equations to their direction fields. So here I'm given four differential equations. So A is dy dt equals t minus 1, B dy dt equals t plus y, C dy dt equals y over 3, and D dy dt equals y times cosine t. So really quickly, let's just mention one more time what a direction field represents, or what a direction field is. So for a given differential equation, and we're considering just first order differential equations here. So for a first order differential equation like this, the direction field is going to show for various points on the ty plane the slopes of the solution y of t. And those slopes are found by evaluating dy dt at various points on the ty plane. So this just gives you kind of a visual representation of what the solutions to the differential equation look like. Okay, so how are we going to actually go about matching these? Well, let's start and maybe pick one of these differential equations that looks maybe a little simpler than the others. So actually, A looks a little bit simpler because there's only a t, right? Dy dt equals t minus 1. This is independent of y. So that makes it a little simpler. So let's think what implications that would have for the direction field, the fact that it's only dependent upon t. So that tells me that on my direction field, I should see my slopes changing for different values of t. But since this is independent of y, I should not see the slopes changing for different values of y. So take a minute and glance at these four and see if you can pick out which direction field would satisfy that. So actually, it's this first one right here. Okay, so first of all, this is my t-axis and this is my y. So let's look at what's happening here. So let's consider y equals 0, what's happening along the line y equals 0. So if I just kind of sketch over these, I see different slopes for different values of t. But then if I move up to the line, to the next line up, which looks like maybe y equals 1/2, something like that, I see that I have the exact same slopes as I did for y equals 0. Right, so they still change in the t direction, but they haven't changed in the y direction. And you'll see that for every y value, I had that same series of slopes, right? So they're changing in the t direction, but they're not changing in the y direction at all. Okay, so that tells me that this first picture matches up with differential equation A, right? Differential equation A is the only one that has that feature that it's only a function of t. Okay, so let's see if there's any other differential equations that maybe stand out to us. Well, look at C. C is kind of the same idea. C is only a function of y. So let's reason through what that would look like. Okay, so if it's only a function of y, then my slopes should change in the y direction, but not in the t direction. So glance at our remaining three different direction fields here and see if any of those stands out to you. Okay, so if I'm looking for something that changes in the y direction but not in the t direction, this second picture is what stands out to me. Okay, so I can see that I'm changing, so here's t once again and here's y, and I can see that my slopes are definitely changing in the y direction, right? If I just pick any vertical way to go. Here, these are definitely changing in the y direction, but they're not changing in the t direction, right? If I stayed at a constant y level, so for example, y equals 0, and I go along here, these slopes are all the same for different t values. Okay, so then I conclude that this direction field corresponds to the differential equation C. Okay, so independent of t. Okay, so now I'm left with B and D, and now both of these include both a t and a y. And I have two direction fields left. So let's see. Let's maybe look at the direction fields themselves and see if either one of them has maybe a feature that stands out to us that we could use to try and distinguish between these differential equations. Okay, so looking at these, I mean, there's a few different features that stand out to me here. One in particular, though, is in this last picture. Look at this series of horizontal slopes that go like this. So that's kind of interesting, right? So let's maybe think about maybe what that would match up with differential equation-wise. Okay, so those horizontal slopes are places where dy dt should equal 0. So looking at differential equation B and differential equation D, is there one of those that you think maybe makes a little more sense to have that diagonal line of slopes of 0? Well, to me, I'm thinking that maybe it's B. So differential equation is B is dy dt equals t plus y. Okay, so then it sort of makes sense that you'd have this line of horizontal slopes because, so for negative t's and positive y's, there's going to be some combination of values for which this adds to 0. And the same thing for negative t and positive y, there's going to be some combination of values where this adds to 0. So that's maybe what we see along this horizontal line here. But let's not conclude that yet. Let's maybe just try to check one or two more features of this just to make sure it actually does match up with t plus y. So what else? Well, I know that when t is positive and y is positive, so in the first quadrant here, in this first quadrant, that all my slopes should be positive, right, since the differential equation is t plus y. And that's true. Okay, so that is definitely in favor of differential equation B. And then also I could use the same logic to say that in this quadrant here, where t is and y are both negative, that I should have all negative slopes. And it looks like that's true. Okay, so that's good. And then of course you could always pick some individual points and test them out. So if I pick along the line y equals 0, then so if y equals 0, then dy dt just equals t. So does that make sense? Well, at t equals 0, it looks like I have a slope of 0. And then as t increases in the positive direction, it looks like my slopes do increase accordingly, and they're all positive. And as t goes in the negative direction, it looks like they are getting steeper in the negative direction. So that's good. So it looks like overall, this matches up pretty well as far as all the things we've checked with differential equation B. So we'll go ahead and say that this is B. But then what we probably want to do is just make sure that our final one, D, actually matches up with this third direction field that we have left. So differential equation D is dy dt equals y times cosine t. So let's look at this direction field. What's one thing that stands out here? Well, from the beginning, I see that along the line y equals 0, I just have all all horizontal tangent lines, or all horizontal slopes. So these all have a slope of 0. So does that make sense? Well, yeah, it does, because when y equals 0, dy dt is going to be 0. Okay, so that lines up. Are there other features that line up? Well, let's think about plugging in y equals 1 to this differential equation. Because if I plug in y equals 1, then I'm just left with cosine of t. So that tells me along the line y equals 1, so at this level here, that if I drew a solution there, that it would have a cosine shape. So let's see if that's actually true. Let's try to draw the solution that goes through the point 0, 1. So this might be a little challenging to do. I don't have a great density of lines here, but generally what's happening? Well, it looks like I should be going up at first. Then I kind of flatten out, and then I go down, 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 down. And then it looks like I kind of flatten out again and start going up. Okay, so that looks like maybe it kind of has a cosine motion. And in general, if I look at this overall, I do kind of see this periodic aspect of it. So I'm able to convince myself then that this really is matching up with differential equation D. And once again, in all of these cases, if you're not sure, just start plugging in some points and see if the slope looks like it matches up